Hey guys, thanks for checking in with STTOP.
Today we're talking about flies.
Like me, people love to hate them. Unlike me though, they actually have a crucial role to play in the future of our planet. We're gonna revel in their uniqueness. Flies are fabulous. Without them, the world would literally fill up with organic waste like plants and dead animals. Some insects, some reptiles, birds, cats, wolves, they'd go hungry. Hail the almighty food chain. Glad to be on top.
It's estimated that 60 billion to 6 trillion invertebrates were killed in the Australian Black Summer bushfires a few years ago. Let me say that again. Invertebrates, like flies, butterflies, even ladybugs. 60 billion of them.
I want to learn to appreciate all of the most infuriating little creatures, because then that means maybe I'll learn to appreciate myself too. I'm going to speak to someone whose love of flies has taken him all the way to the ancient forests of Chile to study them and collect their DNA. Bry the Fly Guy, aka Dr. Bryan Lessard. That name come about?
Turns out I became a world expert in flies, and I kind of embraced it and just became Bry the Fly Guy.
I really want to know, why do you like flies so much?
Believe it or not, but I actually used to hate flies as a kid. I thought they were annoying and were useless. It wasn't until I started studying them at uni where I realized, looking at them under the microscope, you can see that they're really pretty. And they do some really cool jobs that we take for granted too, out in nature.
Yeah, flies are some of the most important decomposing animals, but other beetles and even like butterfly caterpillars, some species only eat rotting flesh too.
Yeah, that's the thing. People think butterflies are cute. A lot of them eat poo and they eat dead bodies. So yeah. Flies aren't looking so bad now, right?
Have you found any new species?
I've been lucky enough to find 150 new species, and I've actually named 50 of them. The first one I named had a bright golden abdomen, so I named it after the one and only Beyoncé, and it's become the Beyoncé fly, Plinthina Beyoncé. Flies have massive roles in our ecosystem that we take for granted. The adults are really important pollinators of native plants, and food that we eat, like mangoes, avocados, and berries that are all pollinated by blowflies. Fun fact, the blowfly can actually carry twice as much pollen than the European honeybee. Maggots are pretty cool too. They're actually really important composters in our rainforests, and they can even reduce the amount of E. coli in your compost in your backyard too. So if we remove the insect food from the bottom of the food chain, it'll have a knock-on effect all the way up to us.
All right, so I now know that we need flies. And I'm guessing that that means no fly spray, right? How does fly spray affect flies, but also, I guess, you know, nature?
So you can definitely put down the fly spray. The problem with fly spray, it also has a knock-on effect in the environment. So you might be spraying like a can of spray to get rid of one or two flies, but that spray eventually settles down into the ground. And when it rains, the rain can actually help wash the fly spray and other insecticides down into rivers, which can poison other insects too. It doesn't just kill flies, it kills all sorts of different insects. And we just don't know what the knock-on effects of these chemicals are too.
Is there a way for us to shoo flies without killing them?
So the best way is just to cover any food with a tablecloth and keep the flies away from it. Another way is just to close the door, use fly screens, and take the rubbish out regularly. Another way to keep flies away and other insects is by planting carnivorous plants like pitcher plants, Venus flytraps around in the garden, or simply shoo it away to pollinate another day.
If we lost flies overnight, no more mangoes, for example.
It's not just the agricultural crop, but it's also the native plants too. So my research has shown even the pesky blowfly can pollinate 15 different types of native plants like gum trees, tea trees, and even grevilleas too. And scientists, they're trying to unravel why these black soldier fly larvae can eat plastic. And there might be something, you know, in the saliva that helps break down those polymers that make plastic what it is. So maybe one day we'll be taking our recycling from the curb, feeding it to these black soldier fly larvae that can do the recycling for us, pretty much.
Thank you so much, Bryan, for coming on and talking to us. I've learned so much, and my mind has been blown in so many different ways.
What? Time flies. Thanks so much for having me, Matt.
So, what are we doing? Make a natural repellent. What worked for you? Host your finding. If you can, get some fly-eating plants or plants that deter flies, like basil, mint, or lavender. Or you can just
chew them away. You can use the hashtag #Stop2030 or #LoveFlies.